Hello friends, here again. We are going to know in this chapter what are the twin prime numbers and the conjecture to which they gave rise. We will also see that there may be two deserts of prime numbers between natural numbers. And to finish, I will present you one of the problems on prime numbers easier to enunciate and more difficult to solve, without solution until today. The Goldbach conjecture. Twin primes. Another aspect of prime numbers is the so-called twin primes. These are prime numbers that are separated by two units. For example, 17 and 19 are twin primes, or 809 and 811. It is hard to accept that if it is surprising that a large number is a prime, there are two very large and almost consecutive prime numbers. We have a prime, then a composite number, immediately followed by a prime. A circumstance that is as particular as being a prime vanishes and reappears immediately, only two units away. It is as if prime numbers were at the mercy of an arbitrary will. And here is the problem. As much as we know that there are infinitely many prime numbers, we do not know how many twin primes exist. The past 23 centuries of mathematical progress have failed to solve one of the enigmas of the theory of numbers. That is, there may be a finite number of twin primes, but truly great, and we would not know. Such an enigma puzzles mathematicians. The largest known twin primes, until May 2018, are these numbers, which were discovered in September 2016, are much smaller than the largest known prime, because they only have 388,342 digits, which means that we could write them in just 155 pages of a dense book. They are still very large numbers, and we could think that, if they are really large, it is possible because there are infinitely many twin primes. Not so fast. In mathematics, things remain to be proven, and this has not been proven. But lately, there have been important advances. In 2013, the American mathematician Yi-Tan Fang first, and the British James Maynard later, did not prove the conjecture, but they got close enough. It is necessary to give a twist to their ideas, which we will know in later chapters. We may doubt whether there can be a set of very large, non-prime, composite numbers between two prime numbers. Here we do have an answer. Between two prime numbers, there may be an amount of non-prime as large as we want. This is also a surprising aspect. We can artificially generate deserts without prime numbers, a vast expanse in which all numbers have divisors, that is, they are composite. We will see it with an example. Let's imagine that we build the following number: 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 equal to 120. This number cannot be a prime, of course, because it is a product of others. But if we add 2 to it, the result, 122, cannot be a prime either, since the result of the operation, 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 plus 2, is necessarily divisible by 2. If we add 3 to it, and for the same reason, the result, 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 plus 3, is divisible by 3. And the same goes for 4 and 5. In mathematics, the product of a whole number by all those that precede it until reaching 1 is called factorial. In our case, factorial of 5 is equal to 120, and for example, factorial of 9 is equal to 362,880. The factorial operation, and although it seems strange, is symbolized by the exclamation mark. That is, 5 factorial is equal to 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 equal to 120. Or 9 factorial is equal to 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 equal to 362,880. Written in a more mathematical way, if n is a whole number greater than 1, then n factorial is equal to the next expression. Well, by the example seen, given an integer n, the numbers n factorial plus 2, n factorial plus 3, n factorial plus 4, n factorial plus 5, etc., n factorial plus n, cannot be primes. Thus, between n factorial plus 2 and n factorial plus n, there cannot be prime numbers. For example, if we want a dessert of 1000 consecutive non-prime numbers, just make the next 1000 operations. But alas, friends, there is a high price to pay. The factorial operation is treacherous. The factorial of a number grows vertiginously as that number grows. For example, 20 factorial is equal to and has 19 digits. So, what will be the factorial of 1001? Well, simply an inconceivable number with 2571 digits. This way of discovering the cells of prime numbers serves only to understand that they can exist, but it does not help us very much in a practical way. Well, this is one way of generating these sequences, but there are also, naturally, authentic non-draughts of primes without resorting to this method. Between 887 and 907, there are 19 non-prime numbers, very naturally, so to find 19 consecutive composite numbers, we do not need to travel up to 20 factorial. Between 31,397 and 31,469, which are still quite small numbers, there are 71 non-prime numbers. Such is the arbitrariness of prime numbers. Christian Goldbach was a German mathematician, secretary of the Academy of Sciences in St. Petersburg. He was a friend of the great Swiss mathematician Leonhard Euler, with whom he held a regular epistolary relationship. Goldbach, like Euler, conscientiously worked on the theory of numbers, but by no means was he as bright. In a letter to Euler in 1742, he expressed his assumption that every integer greater than 5 could be written as a sum of 3 prime numbers. He had numerically proved this in countless cases. Following an analysis, Euler replied that this assumption could be reduced to a simpler one, to which Goldbach replied that, indeed, every even number greater than 2 can be written as a sum of 2 prime numbers. And this is the assumption that has remained as the Goldbach conjecture, because, despite all the efforts of devoted mathematicians, it has not been proven. Over 275 years, in May 2018, have gone by, and no mathematician has been able to prove it. We must be humble and think that the easiest assumption sometimes requires a superior brain to be proven. To this day, that brain has not appeared. As the great English mathematician Godfrey H. Hardy said, "Every fool can ask a question about prime numbers that the wisest man cannot answer." Goldbach's conjecture had been verified by means of computers for all even numbers up to 4 multiplied by 10 raised to 18. For small numbers, the conjecture is very easy to check. The following example is done up to number 16. And note that there are several ways to do this as our number grows. But verifying a conjecture, even up to astronomical numbers, is not proving it, as there may be an infinity of cases where it is not true. Mathematicians have the habit of not taking anything for granted, and this is why this conjecture is not a theorem. Here we finish the chapter. We have seen how the theory of numbers, and more specifically prime numbers, hide mysteries of very easy enunciation that resist being revealed. That is its attraction. In the next chapter, we will know what the Fermat prime numbers and Mersenne prime numbers are, and their usefulness today. Thank you for watching.